don't believe we've been formally introduced. Not in this era, anyway. I wish I could explain all this strangeness, but there isn't much time. The short of it is, you saw my beloved Juno. And for a brief moment, I thought she might occupy this tender body of yours. But something went wrong. And now, she's back out there, adrift. Oh, she was magnificent once. One of a race of beautiful, wonderful creatures. They created your kind. Did you know that? Your people were tools to them. That's all you have ever been. That's all you should ever be. One day soon, I hope. For the world is nearly ready for her return. Wired. Prepared for a second coming. Uh-oh. Here they come. Those Templars. Or maybe assassins this time. Idiots. All of them. I envy you. It was her wish that I be here to greet her. It was her experiment that made it possible for my rebirth as one of these things. Ah!
Stay down! Get down on your back! Now!
He's got a gun!
Guide me into the grave, beloved! I am your instrument!
Put the gun down! Drop it!
Drop your weapon!
Clear! Clear! Check his vitals.
He's bleeding fast.
Check the victim.
Are you okay? Can you hear me? Hello? Talk to me. You all right?
There you are. Thank God. I hope you feel well. You look good. Can you stand? Good. Try walking around. A doctor came by, said there wasn't anything to worry about. That the liquid in the syringe was far, far below a lethal dose. I feel terrible about all this. About everything. All our evidence pointed to you, but it was John all along. God, the things we found on his computer. Whatever you need, we'll provide. You've done an amazing job. Speaking of which, our trailer is finished. Would you like to see it? I owe you that much. There we go. I uploaded it to your database. You can watch it here or at your Animus. I think you'll love it. It really captures the essence of the era. So, take care. And again, thank you.
In a world where pirates rule the waves, these men will discover that nothing is sacred and everyone is committed to rum, plunder, and women.
Hola, ladies.
This summer, Abstergo Entertainment invites you aboard for the adventure of a lifetime. So sharpen your cutlasses, shine your hooks, and sail with the Devils of the Caribbean. This virtual experience is not being rated.
Fanatic is the best word, I suppose.
We take who we can get.
Exactly, exactly. Well put. We saw in John an opportunity to burrow deeper into Abstergo's cloud servers, and I'm not ashamed to say we took it. Not realizing, of course, that he was enlisting you to help him. And to blame, should anything go wrong. I suppose it all worked out very nicely in the end. Most of it, anyway.
What Sean really wants to say is, if you're up for more hacking, we are too. John gave you level 3 security clearance before he died. You should use it. The assassins don't have the resources to pay you like the Templars do, but we'll make it worth your while.
Look, we should really cut it short, Bex. 20 seconds.
All right. Good luck.
Cheers, mate. And top-notch work. Really top. Give yourself a pat on the back. And happy hacking.
Gentlemen, how do you find it here?
It will work for us. But our goal must be to scatter our operations. To live and work among the people we protect, just as Altair Ben La'ahad once counseled.
Well, until that time, it's yours as you see fit.
Edward, Captain Woods Rogers survived his wounds. He has since returned to England, shamed and in great debt, but no less a threat.
I will finish that job when I return. You have my word. Evening, Anne.
Edward?
I'll be sailing for London in the next few months. I'd be a hopeful man if you were beside me.
England's the wrong way around the globe for an Irish woman.
Will you stay with the assassins?
No, I haven't got that kind of conviction in my heart. You?
In time, aye. And my mind is settled and my blood is cooled.
Sail ho! Coming into the cove!
You're a good man, Edward. And if you learn to keep settled in one place for more than a week, you'll make a fine father, too. Of all the money that e'er I had, I spent it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none. Me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't. So felt me a parting glass. Good night.
Did you always know how to sail a boat?
The Jackdaw is a ship, Jenny. Not a boat.
But did you always know?
No. No, I learned after leaving Bristol.
After you left Mother?
Well, I didn't leave your... I didn't leave without saying goodbye, that is. It was an arrangement, you see, between your mother and me.
She said you left her. She said you always talked about sailing the boat and making money in the New World.
I did always want to sail a ship. That's true. But not for a lark. To support us. To take care of her. And you.
Not me. Mother said you didn't know about me. She said you wrote only once a year, and that she never knew where to find you.
That's all true, and I'm sorry for that. If I'd known earlier, I might have come home. I hope that I would have.
Well, you were busy. That's what I think.
I was, but that wouldn't have mattered.
Can I steer your boat?
Boat? I see no boat here. Do you?
I mean ship, obviously. I don't see the difference anyway.
Ah, it's a very simple one, Jenny. A ship can carry a boat, but a boat cannot carry a ship.
Why then, everything is a ship, large and small. But for my toy boat, the one I take into the bath with me.
That's a clever way of seeing it. Is it hard to talk about Caroline, Jenny? About your mother?
No. She passed some years ago. I miss her, but it's all right.
Was she in pain?
I don't know. I don't think so. She was very happy for quite some time. Then, not so happy. I didn't see her much after that. Then, she was gone.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I wasn't there.
It's all right. You're here now. And we're on an adventure.
Only a little one, I hope. Can't handle too many more surprises.
You think we'll see a whale?
Yes, there's a very good chance.
And what about pirates? Will I see pirates?
No. Not much chance of that, I think.
Oh, that's rather sad. I should have liked to have seen one.
Tell you what, Jenny. As soon as these winds die a little, I'll let you steer the Jackdaw. One little trick at the helm before sundown.
Yay!
Miss Jennifer Kenway, may I introduce myself?
Jennifer Scott, if you please.
I'm sorry,
My daughter was raised by her mother, Caroline, until she passed away some years ago. Jenny prefers to use her surname to mine.
Ah, please forgive my ignorance.
I will. She may not.
Father, help me.
This little rascal, however, is a Kenway. What's wrong, Haytham?
I can't see the stage.
Up we go. How's that?
Fine. But won't your arms tire?
Hey, I'm not so old as that. But if they do, then we shall quit this posh gig and go and meet your mother for some chocolate and whites. How's that sound?
Yes, please.
Okay, hush now.